is now a new, like, gay icon. I don't know her.
She's been a gay icon.
Really?
Beautiful in every single way.
That's our new podcast.
Bends.
I think we need security or someone with a
car. Oh. Here we were. We're about to fly up and be above everyone.
I don't have that kind of clearance.
That was Carmen. Okay. We'll wait for you. Oh. Tell
Should we just wait in here?
Bye.
Hi, how are you?
Good, how are you?
Yeah.
Oh my god. I'm so moisturized.
Really?
Yeah.
That's me.
Hey guys. I'm just wearing panties under this.
So am I.
I saw.
Wait, I have like nude panties on.
Ooh! Hi. Wow, you can't even tell. Yep.
Full on boxers.
Full on full coverage.
Well,
full
under coverage. My panties, I have boxers too, so. Yeah. She likes to be prepared. Okay.
More over there.
She's hearing.
She's here.
She's hearing.
She has Jade.
Hi.
To present to Miles, and then afterwards, Tegan.
So are we going to be in our seats the whole time?
You can sit in the front, or if you want, you can just come from the back. Maybe easier just to come from around. My three other fabulous co-founders, Aaliyah J. Daniels, Christopher Rodriguez, and LaShawn McGee. I am nothing without my two work wives and my actual husband. We want to welcome you as a group because the importance of tonight, of course, is celebration. We started Reverie almost 3 years ago. I would like to introduce the world's biggest fashion and lifestyle phenomenon and recipient of the 2017 Recognition Award last year, Gigi Gorgeous.
Because he walked in the room 6 foot and he had these like lavender and like pink, like long down to the thong, like braids, like giving you like a gay poetic justice type of situation. And he had on the tallest heels like I think I've ever seen in my life. And that's when I knew that this is just who he is. This is Miles. He just stands out. And whether it's his warm, positive energy or his stilettos, Miles is not the type to go overlooked. The first night, I remember we were in someone's hotel room, and Miles decided, just randomly, and I've only known him about maybe about 10 hours, and he not only decides to just perform one of his original songs to a track that I'm almost positive was stolen. He raps, he not only rapped the first verse, he rapped the second verse, sang the chorus, and performed the whole song in heels in this maybe 200 square foot hotel room. And ladies and gentlemen, that is Miles J. Unequivocally, vocabulary himself. His self-awareness and confidence has helped so many LGBTQ people, and I know he has plans to continue to challenge intolerance. She relentlessly fights for others, and I'm so proud to call this beautiful black queen. My sister. And now, whoever is going to put on a video is going to show you just how sick Nikki actually is.
I know how difficult it is to love yourself. When everybody else is telling you that you are nothing and that you're worth nothing. But let me tell you something, the sooner that you say, I don't care what anybody says, the better. That is the point where you just couldn't care and you start loving yourself more. You start to be more out there with whatever you're doing and you start to try new things. And let me tell you, that is a beautiful thing in and of itself. And for all of you haters, I said, please, open your eyes, sympathize, empathize, realize, and love yourself.
I would like to present the 2018 Visibility Award to Miles J.
Woo!
so much, Reverie. Y'all are fab. You know, an hour ago, when I decided to write this speech in the car, I thought to myself, bitch, I should have did this yesterday. But here we are. Chicken scratch on a ripped piece of paper. Such is my life. A black scribble in a sea of straight, white, privileged paper.
Okay.
I never felt like I fit inside the lines. My mind always wandered beyond them, which often got me in trouble. You can't draw that, Miles, because I said so, Miles. Who is Sean Cody, Miles? Why are you so extra, Miles? Why aren't you? Why aren't you more kind? Why aren't you minding your business? Why aren't you doing what you want? Why aren't you letting you be you? Why aren't you you? If I'm extra, then they are ordinary. So they tried to take pieces of me until I was nothing, and they were extraordinary. So I fought back. I fought with my family. I fought with people I thought were my friends. The internet. And tonight, I'm reclaiming my time. The time I lost fighting with the world. The time I lost fighting myself. So I stand here now, tall, gender fluid, gender non-conforming, and proud. It took me so long to get here. And I know so many people like me are on similar journeys. Alone, fighting the world. And I ask myself, who is going to protect us? Those who don't fit the binary. Cause bitch, we should have did that yesterday.
That's it.